Not all stars live for the same length of time, and not all stars are the same size either. Stars come in many temperatures, too. Stars' lifetimes, sizes, and temperatures are all important to consider while searching for life in the universe outside of Earth, because these factors determine the likelihood that we will find complex life, or life at all, on a star's orbiting planets. A star is born when a cold cloud of gases, mainly hydrogen and helium, collapses due to the force of gravity. As the cloud is collapsing, it spins faster and faster due to angular momentum. Angular momentum is the concept that smaller objects rotate faster. Think of an ice skater. When she is spinning, she will spin more slowly when her arms are outward. When she tucks in her arms, her speed will increase. The cloud heats up due to the increasing pressure as it compresses. The potential energy of gravity becomes kinetic energy, which then causes an increase in temperature. The cloud will then flatten into a disk because as it is spinning and getting hotter, the collective motion of the whole system causes everything not going in this common direction to be swept into it. Everything going in the other direction will eventually be assimilated. This process transitions the cloud of chemicals into star-sized masses called protostars. As these protostars begin to stabilize, their cores get hotter and denser. When their core temperatures reach a certain Kelvin temperature in the millions, fusion begins. This is called the main sequence phase, and it is where stars spend 90% of their lifetimes. In this phase, stars burn nitrogen into helium in a process called nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion takes place in the star's core. The force of gravity pulling inward in the star's core is balanced by the push of energy emitted from nuclear fusion in a process called gravitational equilibrium. When a star runs out of hydrogen to fuse in its core, there is no longer gravitational equilibrium because there is no longer an outward push from the fusion in the core. Gravity begins to pull inward, causing the pressure and consequently temperature to increase. Once it reaches 100 million degrees Kelvin, hydrogen shell fusion begins outside of the core and restores gravitational equilibrium. The star is now a red giant. At 100 million degrees Kelvin, the core is hot enough for helium fusion to begin. Helium fusion is the process of helium fusing into carbon. When the helium runs out, the star never reaches a hot enough temperature, 600 million degrees Kelvin, to begin carbon fusion. So when helium runs out, gravitational equilibrium is permanently broken. Shell fusion becomes violent, and the outer layers of the star are blown off. A planetary nebula is formed. Depending on the star's size, it will either die as a white dwarf if it's a low-mass star, or end in a supernova or become a black hole if it's a high-mass star. A star with a large mass will have a higher luminosity or brightness, a higher temperature, a larger radius, and will be emitting bluer, faster wavelengths of light than a star with a smaller mass. A star with a larger mass will also have a shorter lifetime than a smaller star. Massive stars have a stronger force of gravity than smaller stars, so they must fuse hydrogen into helium faster than a smaller star to balance against the force of gravity pulling inward. The bigger the star, the less likely we are to find complex life on its orbiting planets. This is because bigger stars have shorter lifetimes, and shorter lifetimes don't allow enough time for complex life on orbiting planets to develop. The longer a star's lifetime, the more likely we are to find life on its orbiters. If a star has an especially long lifetime, like our Sun, it is increasingly likely to find more complex organisms on its orbiting planets, like there is on Earth, because they have had more time to evolve and develop. The masses of stars are the most important thing to look for when searching for life in the universe. The more massive the star, the shorter it will live, and consequently will be less likely to have life, let alone complex life, on its orbiting planets. No star can live forever, and eventually our sun will die out. Not for another 5 billion years, though, so it isn't something we need to worry about just yet.